3-day orientation program was held in District Institute of Education and Training, Nalanda, Bihar, from 26th April to 28th April 2019. The objective was to mentally sensitize the elementary school teachers about different findings of National Achievement Survey 2017, which is already available on its website. It is necessary that all the participants should be able to read and understand subject-wise and class-wise data for their district and state in national context. Total 160 teachers from 20 blocks were invited randomly for this orientation program together with their respective BOs and BRPs. On grassroots level, there were some confusion regarding the similarity of questions asked in annual and half-yearly exam of class 3, 5 and 8 conducted regularly in government schools of Bihar and items asked in National Achievement Survey 2017. The difference between these two were presented with some examples. It was informed to the participant that items of NAS 2017 were not from their textbook, but were based on practical implementation of subject-wise and class-wise concept already discussed in their textbook. If a child is getting some conceptual information in his or her classroom, he or she should recall and recognize that related items from his or her surroundings. For example, if a classroom teacher is teaching about the word arm, mango, then children should recognize the two letters A and M in his real life situation, such as from any advertisement board, newspaper, etc., and should be capable of recognizing the fruit mango from collection of many other different items. One another example was given that if our objective is to improve competency about different geometrical shapes, then by folding a piece of paper which is easily available in local situation, we may create an environment to recognize different geometrical shapes in their surroundings. In a classroom, some children respond frequently, some respond seldom, and some respond never. This does not mean that the child is not capable. He or she may have a different viewpoint or different way of communication. Classroom communication should be open for all. Class discipline can't force anyone to sit quietly. A school should maintain portfolio of each and every child. This will help us in taking special care if a child is not actively participating in group work. Most of the time we do assessment for learning or assessment of learning, but learning outcomes suggest for assessment as learning. For example, child may have information about volume and density separately, but how these two are interrelated may not be clear for him. Or a child may speak or write correctly the name of every state with its capital, but may not locate on map. Then our classroom process should include such skills, because learning outcomes demand such competency. To improve this, we may assign some tasks in small heterogeneous groups of that class. There is no particular medicine to improve low learning outcomes, but we learn through sharing of experiences and performing simple tasks in group or community will help to improve this. If learning outcomes of a child improves in any topic, then he or she like to share this with his or her family members and friends. Children don't like to hear others' voice silently or for a long time. They like to do simple work in their own style. It is wise to use this psychological truth for improving learning outcomes. Some participants put their day-to-day problems. They complained that activity-based teaching learning process takes more time to complete that topic but they are supposed to finish the syllabus in the allotted time duration. Home condition of most of the children are not favorable for their academic improvement. In such situation, how is it possible to improve competency as explained in learning outcomes published by MHRD in April 2017? Dr. Vishal advised some simple tricks to deal this challenging situation. He suggests them to map one activity with more than one subject concept for more than one class. One TLM can be used in explaining more than one concept and in more than one subject and in different way. In real life situation, we may experience a single event which relates more than one causes and effect. Thunder of clouds, light and sound happens in one single event. The more important point is that teacher need managerial skill to manage student, to manage situation, to manage syllabus, to manage different activities, to manage classroom disciplines, etc. We need to develop small games based on subject concept for classroom situation as a tool for assessment as learning. All the participants were worried to know that learning outcomes of class 10 is less than class 8, class 8 is less than class 5, and class 5 is less than class 3. At last, participants were asked to develop an activity or games for any one learning outcomes from the list of those in which correct responses are less than 50% in district Nalanda. They all took it seriously and shared their view in block-wise group presentation. Now we are planning to map different activities with different subject concepts with locally available resources so that it may be helpful to use it in classroom situation to improve children competency. Thank you.
शिक्षक तो वह एक मोमबत्ती के समान होता है जो स्वयं